V.com. Toro's Hockey is brought to you by Farmers Union Insurance, Gooseneck Implement, Mattress Firm, Liberty Tax, and Coulter Energy. Now let's go live to the Farmers Union Insurance pregame show with Ken Oda.
Hello and welcome. As the big voice said, I'm Ken Oda getting you ready for Toro's and Bismarck Bobcats, the Toro's. Come in squandering a two-goal lead last night. Went into the third period leading 3-1 in Bismarck, only to have the Cats come storming back and win 6-3. They tied the game with a couple quick goals in the third, and then it was a pretty even period. In fact, the Toros appeared to take a 4-3 lead with about 5.5 minutes left to go. That penalty, or that goal, was waved off. The next shift, the Toros take a penalty. The Bobcats score on the power play. And then the wheels came off. Another one right after that ensuing faceoff. And an empty netter to push the final to 6-3. Toros hope to have short memories and put that in the rearview mirror and get back at it tonight. The Toros did get two goals from Kyler Clevin last night, as well as one from Billy Immonen. Clevin's really come on of late. He had a hat trick before the Christmas break on November 30th against St. Cloud, a two-goal game against Bismarck on December 7th, and then a two-goal game against Bismarck last night. So hopefully Clevin can stay hot, as he's put up seven goals in his last six games. Aside from that, Nick Armstrong Kincaid had another assist. He remains on pace to just destroy the Toro single season records. He's on pace for 69 points and 40 goals. 40 goals and 69 points, which will both be records. Currently, both records are held by Miroslav Mucha, who had 30 goals and 55 points three seasons ago. Toro's going back to Ben Garrity in net, who has been strong of late. He had a .920 save percentage from November 11th through December 14th. A little bump in the road in the third period last night, but hopefully Benny can be back to form tonight. The Bobcats, surprisingly, are going back to Andrew Miller. Miller has a 3-2-3 goals against average and just an .868 save percentage against the Toros. Toros did get three past Yulin last night, but those were the first three goals they've scored on him all season. We will send you out to commercial so that we can get back here in time for all of the pregame festivities here on the Minotauros Network.
Hi, Toro fans. Kyler Clevin here to tell you hockey can be rough, and so can driving in North Dakota winter. If you have an accident, bring your car or truck to Minot's Finest Collision Center. Corey and his staff are clearly Minot's Finest. Call them at 701-839-0989. Minot's Finest Collision Center. They are really Minot's Finest.
What's the best birthday party option in town? Toro's Hockey. You supply the birthday boy or girl, the Toros do the rest. Designated party areas and all sorts of perks to make your birthday kid feel special on his or her special day. Kids, it's up to you. Tell your parents or guardian that you want to celebrate your birthday with Tank and the Toros. For more information, call 701-852-0101 or visit MinotaurosHockey.com. Toros Hockey, making your birthday special. Join the charge.
Take care of your feet and they'll take care of you. The foot and ankle specialists at Trinity Health can help with both surgical and non-surgical solutions. So patients who suffer from foot and ankle related issues can say, so long heel pain, catch you later corns, hasta la vista hammer toes. Relieve pain now and help prevent future discomfort. Diagnosis and treatment is available today. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. when I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line to that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
Captain's Cove Seafood Restaurant invites you in for your favorite seafood as well as steak, chicken, and lots of great burgers and sandwiches. The Cove has fish and chips, crab, shrimp, and all-you-can-eat meals. Captain's Cove, where fishing is made easy. 1735 South Broadway in Minot.
Throughout the areas we serve, First International Bank and Trust employees are actively involved in helping our customers and communities grow. This is Kevin Vigestead from First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Whether it's coaching a Little League team, leading through involvement with nonprofit organizations, or a proud Beaver booster, know that all of us at First International Bank and Trust are committed to giving back to the places where we live and work.
His wife's words echoed in his mind.
You never fix anything around here.
Well, today that would change. He would fix the water heater. He'd show her that he was the handyman of this house. He was more than capable. Oh, no. Covered it. August 14th, 2008. Talk to farmers. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Underwritten by Farmers Truck Fire Insurance Exchanges and Affiliates. Products not available in every state.
Hey, Toro fans. Ken Hoda here. Whether you need to insure your auto, home, or life, call the Miranda Schuler Farmers Agency at 838-8144. Or better yet, do what I do and stop in. They keep free candy on their desks.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at libertytax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
I guess I don't have to tell you that I've been unsatisfied with your performance lately. You're showing your age. I think I even see a bald spot. It's time for Tires Plus.
Tires Plus has the prescription to satisfy all your vehicle needs, from tires to repair. Stop settling for average performance. Trust your locally owned Tires Plus. Some common side effects may occur, such as family safety, feelings of happiness, strange smiles that last all day, free courtesy rides, and raccoon hands. Actually, that's not real. I was just checking to see if you're listening. Thinking tires? Think Tires Plus.
The Job Connection, brought to you by Classic Hits 1390 KRRZ.
Coulter Energy is hiring day supervisors, night operators, and field assistants. Must be able to pass a drug and alcohol test along with a physical. Must be able to work away from home in extended hours. Coulter Energy offers competitive wages, including drive time wage and non-taxable per diem, and benefits. Send resume to jobs at coulterenergy.ca or online at coulterenergy.com. Coulter Energy is an equal opportunity employer.
For info about this job and others, head to ClassicHits1390.com.
Toros fans, Toros goalie Ben Garrity here. You don't have to stop a 100-mile-an-hour slap shot to make big saves like me. Download FanSaves, the free mobile app on Apple and Android, and save big bucks all around town at Toros Partners. Places like Mattress Firm, Two Dark Motorsports, Applebee's, Qdoba, and Magic City Hoagies all give you ways to save. So download FanSaves today and save money all around Minot just for being a Toro fan.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink in Mesa Arena. We're getting you ready for Toros and Bismarck Bobcats. We are just about ready for the pregame festivities. So we'll turn you over to the PA and Seth Hagen.
From the seats to the locker rooms, the Trinity training room to the box office, and from the hardworking ice crew to our fans cheering in the stands, no one in the North American Hockey League has a home like us. We're proud to call the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena home, and we ask you to treat it with respect. So please do not stand in the seats, throw garbage on the floor, or damage the bathrooms. Toro fans, you're a huge part of our family, and this is our house.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Pepsi Rink in Mesa Arena for tonight's North American Hockey League game. Tonight's matchup features the visiting Bismarck Bobcats Huggins-y or Minot Minnesota. So I've got one question, Minot. Are you ready for Minnesota's hockey? Welcome to the IC or my dog Minnesota. It's time to meet your Planet Pizza Minnesota starring lineups. So here you go from Rosemont, Minnesota, wearing sweater number 29, Ben Garrity. Starting on defense from Victoria, Minnesota, wearing sweater number 15, Nikolai Sharshenko. Starting at the other defense from St. Michael, Minnesota, wearing sweater number 26, Brennan Kulak. Starting at the forward from Alexandria, Virginia, wearing sweater number 21, Nick Armstrong, Starting another forward from Senjoki, Finland, wearing sweater number 18, Ville Immonen. And finally, yet another forward from Fargo, North Dakota, wearing sweater number 20, Kate Stubbs. The Toros Quick Lube and N83 Fireworks Sanitary captain of the game is Willie Wagner. The Toros are head coached by Marty Murray. He is assisted by Shane Wagner and Wyatt Westland Chuck. That's your Planet Pizza Minnesota's starting lineups. Now, fans, at this time, we ask that you please rise and kindly remove all headgear as we welcome Steve Brown to the ice for the singing of the Star Spangled Banner.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. In the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
thanks, XXL Energy for keeping the lights on at the Mesa.
With the pregame festivities just about out of the way, we're almost ready to go here in the Magic City. Toros and Bobcats in a packed Pepsi rink. We're going to have over 2,000 people here tonight. Excuse me. Ugh. Toros come in 16-9-3. The Bobcats 18-5-4. Toros will be working from right to left on your computer monitor or radio dial, depending on how you are tuned into the Minotauros Network. Wearing the home cream sweaters, cream socks, cardinal red buckets, breezers, and gloves. Black trim, cardinal red numbers, cream names on black name plates for the men from the Magic City. Puck has dropped and we are underway. Moved along to the near side. Pass ahead to the near side. Jopie fires one up off the glass. It rings to the far side. Big collision. Finally, the puck squirts free. It's picked up by Charchenko. Toros can't gain the zone, and neither can the Bobcats, as that long pass was offside. So the Toros and the Cats. Andrew Miller in the net for the Cats, 11-2-1 on the season, a 2.22 goals against average and a 9.12 save percentage. Is 3-2 against the Toros. Ben Garrity in net for the Toros. He is 12-7-2 on the season, a 3.25 goals against average and a 9.03 save percentage. There's a shot that's blocked. And now a penalty coming. Who's it on? Holding the call. Who are they taking? They're taking Grant Johnson. So right away, the Toros go to the power play. Toros power play. They had one last night, one power play goal, that is, bringing their percentage up to 14.9%. That is 19th in the league. The Bobcats on the kill are 87.1%. That is 7th in the North American Hockey League. Cats win the draw and send it all the way down. So the Toros retreat and retrieve. It'll be Skinner out from behind the Toro cage. We've played a minute 8 seconds so far. Toros on the power play for another minute 43. Skinner through neutral, gains the line, leaves off to the far side for Ness, trying to bull his way down the wall. It squirts free. Buchholz finds Russell looking across. He wanted Ness. The pass was just out of his reach, and the Cats send it all the way down. 1:22 left on the power play. Welcome into the Clevins watching in Fargo. We are interactive here on the Minotauros Network. Shoot an email to Koda at Minotauros Hockey, K-O-D-A at MinotaurosHockey.com, or tweet at us at Minotauro Hockey, MinotauroHockey, or tweet at me personally at Ken_Oda, K-E-N_O-D-A. Toros failed to gain the zone again, and now it's ahead for Jopie. He's looking to challenge shorthanded. A good stick by Brennan Coet ends that bid, however. And now the Cats will start up ice. This is O'Connell ahead. Armstrong Kincaid chips it deep. OC can't chase it down. Far side, Immonen does. He holds and plays it in behind. O'Connell's alone in front. Armstrong Kincaid tried to go there, but the pass was to the wrong side. Toro start up ice once again with 24 seconds on the power play. Coet tries to dump it in. It's broken up. It'll roll towards the goaltender, who swats it to the near side, and then the Bobcats send it the rest of the way down. Just 15 seconds left on the Toro power play. This is Dahlin. Carries ahead on the far side. He's poked as he gains the line, and the Bobcats come full strength. Toros control in their own zone. This is Krull quickly up for Dolan. Dolan gains the line, tries a shot, and that's gloved and held by Miller for a whistle. Shots on goal now 2-0 in favor of the Toros. Game still scoreless early on, 16:51 left to play here. In period number one. Bouncing puck, eventually controlled by Grant Johnson and the Bobcats. He played it ahead for Chladek. It's off the mark. Westland breaks it up but can't hold on to the puck. Klein rolls it into the Toro zone. Krull takes Johnson off the puck. And the Toros corral. Wasberg met by a pair of Bobcats, so he plays it back around to the far side. Krull starts Westland up. Westland comes across for Dolan. Dolan gains the line. Dolan looking to carry deep and then throw into the middle. It didn't get through to Westland. And going the other way is Rodna. Toro's taken away from him, and Bartu sends it deep. And then steps off the ice for a change. Nesline over the wall. Ness with a big hit. And the puck's taken away by the Toros in their own zone. Bjorgi gains the red line and chips it deep. It bounces on net. And Miller has to hold on. 15:58 left to play here in period number one. Still no score. Toros still with the only two shots of the game. Draw will be to the right of Miller. Coet rings it deep. Argindigi can't stop that. Ness does. Now they'll dig for it in the corner. Eventually the Cats find it. It's swept around to the near side. Brennan Coet pinches down, keeps it alive, throws it down low for OC. OC with a nifty move gets himself out of the corner and then plays up top Coet. Coet sweeps across for Peterson. It was off the mark, so Peterson just chips it deep. Argindigi trying to walk out of the far corner. He's hassled the entire way by Gower. Played into the middle for Ness. He couldn't hold on, and now the puck's out to neutral. Coet uses the glass to ring that deep. O'Connell's the first to it on the far side. Punches it even deeper. Kevin Ness taken off the puck by the referee. Toro still control. This is Clevin. Clevin looking into the middle. It was able to get all the way through to Russell. Now the puck's out to neutral. Dumped back in. The Toros touch up and they'll pursue. Gower behind his own cage. Mishandles and then it's turned over to Clevin. Clevin plays back to the point in Charchenko. Charchenko with a long shot. Tipped just up and over to the crossbar. And then trying to bank it in off the goaltender was Clevin. That didn't work. And the Cats go the other way with speed. This is Granis. He's got Irie with him, but they're offside with 14:44 left to play here in period number two. And now Charchenko and Granis exchanging words. Perhaps a little carryover from some of their post-whistle battles last night. Good-sized crowd here in the Mesa. People still coming in. Stauber carries down the wall, tries a shot, it hits Granis. Granis trying to work it back to Stauber, but it's picked off by Armstrong Kincaid. He's tied up by Granis. Hillman looks across. Quick shot goes up and over. Rebound to the near side. Granis touches back to the point in Stauber. Stauber's long shot through traffic. Got redirected out front. And somehow found a way into the net. That one pinballed around a bit. And I'm still not entirely sure how that ended up behind Garrity. They give the goal to Stauber. I think it was tipped out front. They say Stauber from Granis. Cats control the draw. Far side, bar two. Couldn't hold on. Now the Toros pursue again. It's picked up by Martel. Martel gains the red line, dumps it deep into the Toro zone. Thrown along the near side. Dolan touches out for Bartu. Bartu gives to Westland. Westland trying to go back to Bartu, but it hits a skate. Krull keeps it at the point. Chops it down the wall, but it's eventually broken up, and the Cats look to attack. Pekowski leaves off for Marty, gets it right back to Pekowski. Shot goes wide. Rebound around to the near side. Dolan tried to chip it out of the zone, but it's kept, and now Marty tries a shot that's blocked by Krull. Loose puck in the far corner. Back to the far point. A long shot. Comes out front to Jupe. Jupe trying to wrap it around. It hits a leg and caroms to the near side half wall. Klein throws across for Jupe. Looking in the middle. A tip doesn't go for the Bobcats. And the rebound comes to the near side. Dahlin finds it. Dahlin leaves behind the net for Bjorgi. Shots on goal, even at two aside, but the Cats have the game's only shot in goal thus far. Ahead for Hargindigi. Hargindigi caught it neatly, and now he has it poked free by Klein as he tried to pull his way to the front. O'Connell frees it up. It rolls down into the corner. Olsen's on it first. Olsen walled off by Ness. Hargindigi and Ness there digging for the Toros. They're both eventually taken off the puck, and it's chopped ahead. Good keep at the line by Peterson. His shot comes to the front of the net, where it's covered for a whistle. 13 minutes exactly left to go here in period number one. Draw will be to the left of Miller, with the Toros trailing one rip. On it first is Magnuson. He's hit hard behind the net. O'Connell trying to chase it down. He plays the body on Schladek as well. Magnuson plays it back to the far side. Gower. Ness forces him to give the puck up, but the Cats do manage to work it out to neutral. And now Aradna and Wasberg come together. Rolled back to the point. Magnuson looking for a lane. Thinks he has one. It's blocked. Ness quickly up for O'Connell. OC carries ahead. Dangles in. Shot. Save made by Miller. Maybe. That may have hit the post. Cats back on the attack. They find the trailer. Gower. Gower in front. That ends up in the corner. Based on the reaction from fans, I was screened on the play by the traffic following the play. I'm thinking it hit perhaps the crossbar and not the goaltender. This is Rodna with a shot. Save made by Garrity. Follow-up try. That hits traffic. And Ness finds it. He gives to OC. OC working on Stauber again. This time he needs to change, so he'll just chip it into the zone. Russell coming. Klevin. Gloves down. Can't get it down to the stick, however. And it's thrown ahead. Charchenko finds it. Plays up the wall in the neutral zone. It comes back to him, and Swartz punches it deep. Coet's the first to it. Takes a hit to make a play. Sweeps it around to the far side. Russell's there. Russell comes to the near side and Klevin. Stauber pinches down to meet him. Stauber throws it in the middle. Hunter Olsen on his backhand. It's in. So, Cats win the draw, leading 2-0 here, less than 9 minutes in. Throwing up the nearest side, it'll roll all the way down. Garrity out of his net stops that. Guides it around to the near side. Armstrong Kincaid picked off the play by Burns. How many times has Burns gotten in the way already? This is ahead for Armstrong Kincaid. Armstrong Kincaid walled off by Stauber. And then played over to Martel. Martel starts the Cats out of their own zone. Comes ahead for Granis. Granis into the middle. That missed everyone. It ends up on the far wall. Skinner gets help from Stibbe. Stibbe chips it up ice. Toros can't find the handle, though. Stibbe is Armstrong Kincaid. Pressure, but it's ahead for Hillman. Hillman dumps it into the Toro zone. Garrity stops the dump in again behind the net. Comes to the near side in Wasberg. Wasberg wanted Dahlin, but he didn't catch it cleanly. Jack Olsen beats Dahlin to it in his own zone. Plays ahead to Jopie. Jopie can't hold on. Westland does and plays back to Kroll at his own blue line. Kroll ahead for Dahlin. Gains the line on the near side. Feathers one in. It's broken up. It was intended for Westland. Back out front for Dahlin, and it's fought off by Miller. That was a reaction save for Miller and a good one. Wasberg dumps it deep again. Bar two gives chase. To the near side it comes. A step up by Charchenko doesn't work. I'm sorry, Wasberg, not Charchenko. Now Dahlin has it. Dahlin poked at the line, and the Toros have to delay. Now he'll just flip one in. It goes up and over the net. Bounces back to the side of the cage. Gower plays it to the near side, and Jopie. Jopie, long toss across, finds Jacob Marty. Marty into the zone. Stepped into by Peterson. He's put down hard there. Puck put deep into the Toros zone. Coette got rocked by Jopie. They dig along the near side wall. O'Connell finds the loose puck and works it ahead. Hargindigi just barely missed a collision.
Toros fans inside, a good old
9:10 left to go here. Imperial number one. Toros out shooting the Cats 5-4, but trail 2-0. It's time for our media timeout. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, we'll have the rest of period number one right here on the Minotauros Network.
Your hands are a vital part of who you are, how you work, play, even how you communicate. When injury or illness strikes, the hand team at Trinity Health will be there to help restore full functionality. We specialize in surgical repairs, hand reconstruction, non-surgical interventions, and occupational therapies. Don't let damage or disorder take away your hands. See the hand team at Trinity Health. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink in Mesa Arena. 9:10 left to play here in period number one on the Minotauros Network, AM1390KRZ, HockeyTV.com. GoToros.com/listen live, and now streaming on the Toros Facebook page as well. Toros trail 2-0. Goals from Stauber and Olsen. For each of them, it's their third of the season. Cats win the draw in their own zone. Ness gets a stick on it. Touched ahead anyways, and it rolls into the Toro zone. O'Connell banks up for Ness. Ness misses Hargindigi. Magnuson dumps it back in. This is Skinner. Wrong around to the near side. O'Connell's pushed off the puck. Schladek chases Charchenko. Charchenko won the race, played it to Hargindigi. Jojo lost it in his skates, however. Schladek looking to work out of the corner. One-timer fought off by Garrity. Rebound given. Quick shot. That one's kicked away by Garrity as well. Banked ahead for O'Connell. Two-on-one for the Toros. Buchholz has Skinner with him. Pass across. One-timer. It's in. And that's a big one for Skinner. Toros needed that one to get back into this. Four skins. It's his fifth of the season. Give Buchholz his 17th assist. Eight, 10 left to go here in the first. Shots even at six aside.
I got it.
Clevin dumps it in. Martel plays it ahead. Irie chops out to neutral. Here's the call of the goal.
Lamp lighter lounge.
Buchholz
scoring. Scoring his fifth goal on the season. Number seven, Sam Skinner. For the assist to number 27, Jay Buchholz.
So skins from Buchholz. Far side, it'll be Krull. Ahead, missed Immonen. Klein finds it, dumps it back into the Toro zone, delayed offside. Now Krull's time is gone, and he works it ahead. He missed Immonen. Thrown ahead on the near side wall. Wasberg can't quite gather it in. Toros throw it up the far side wall. They work on the far side, but eventually the Cats bowl their way out to neutral. Armstrong Kincaid takes it back, gains the line. Delays, tries a backhander that's blocked into the corner. Up to the point, Wasberg tries a shot, it's blocked. Stibbe after it, but Jack Olson beats him to it. Schwartz looks ahead. Hunter Olson couldn't find it. Now it's quickly touched up by Wasberg for Armstrong Kincaid. Armstrong Kincaid and Stibbe working alone while the rest of the Toros change. And the Cats take it away. Hunter Olson gets it out to neutral where Charchenko takes over. Skinner drops it back to Charchenko. Near side, Armstrong Kincaid. Delays. Now looking to buy time. Tries a shot. It hits a leg. Caroms to the corner. Good poke there by Bartu. Keeps it alive for the Toros. Eventually, the Cats' Giopi steps in and takes it away. Pekowski hit hard on the near side. The puck rolls to the Toro blue line. Up ice for Bartu. Poked away from him to the far side wall. Jacob Marty just hacks that one down towards the Toro end of the ice. Won't go far enough for icing, so Charchenko has to play. Leaves off for Skinner. Skinner flubs it along the wall. Dahlin finds it. Bails the Toros out. Bartu ahead for Westland. Kicks it into the zone. Looks to chase it down. He takes Magnuson into the wall, but Gower's there. Two Toros step into Gower as he throws it out to neutral. Three on two for the Bobcats as they hit the line. They find the trailer. Jopi, his quick pass is blocked off by Bjorgi. Ness taking off the puck, and Jopi slow to get up. This is O'Connell. OC crisscrossing with Ness, gains the line, then leaves off for Ness. Ness, backhand try, ends up in behind. Peterson finds it, throws it on net, it's blocked out front. Ness trying to go back to Peterson, but it's cut off by Marty, who hacks that out to neutral ice, and Bjorgi. Toros dump it back into the offensive zone. Stauber will be the first to it. Ness is on his hip pocket. Stauber holding behind his net. Martel carries out, tries the far side. Dumped in, and Garrity will hold for a whistle.
B as in boy, H as in Harold, and A as in animal, at 03BHA. A Maroon Town Country Van, please move your vehicle. It is locking in blood drive truck.
Draw to the right of Garrity. Long shot kicked away by Garrity. Far side, Wasberg's on it. Rings it around to the near side. 4:25 to go here in the first. Toros trail 2-1. Russell spins it out to neutral. Players fall down on the far side. Cats keep it alive. Buchholz plays the body. Now Kroll lets it roll. It comes back to Stauber at the point. Long shot. Tip out front by Johnson. Ends up in behind the net. Johnson trying to get it to the front for Rodna. It doesn't go. Martel plays down the wall for Rodna. Clevin has it. Works it up ice for Buchholz. Buchholz into the zone. Comes across for Russell. In for Clevin. It ends up in behind the net. Thrown back out front. Charchenko steps into one. It hits a leg. Bounces in behind the net. Far side, Irie leaves it back behind the cage for Stauber. Glass and out. This will roll the distance for an icing. Draw will be to the left of Miller. One back. This is Skinner with a long shot. That's blockered up and over by Miller. Armstrong Kincaid. Keeping it alive, gets spun down. Eventually the Cats bowl it out to neutral. And now Chladek's going to go. Are they going to take a Toro too? So the Toros back to the power play. I did too. I thought they were going to take both, but they're just taking Schlattic. And now the Bobcats over to complain. Still waiting on what the call was. I assume it's a rough. So, Toros to the power play. It looks like it's going to be a 2 and a 10. Still waiting on the Cats to put an extra player in the box. So the Toros will go to the power play for 2 minutes. Toros win the draw, but it misses Stibbe. And so the Toros have to retreat and retrieve. They do. Stibbe starts up ice. Tries to dangle in. O'Connell has it poked free, but it'll be kept by Kroll. Kroll down the wall for Stibbe. Stibbe holding. Looking for a lane, then gives to OC. OC back to Stibbe. Stibbe with a shot, blocked out front, and then a cover by Miller.
29.
So a 2 and a 10 for spearing is the call.
Serving the 2 minute penalty will be number 18 for Bismarck, Hunter Olsen.
Toros win the draw. Up top for Kroll, looking for a lane. Instead, he gives up to Immonen. Immonen back up top to Kroll. Back to Immonen. Back to Kroll up top of the umbrella, looking for a lane. Doesn't have one. He comes to Stibbe, top of the near circle. Stibbe walks across and then goes over to Immonen. Immonen walks in, delays, no lane. Drops to Armstrong Kincaid. Armstrong Kincaid goes back up top, and that'll miss Stibbe. Minute 3 on the man advantage. Stibbe winds it up. Gains the line and then chips it deep. Klein hammers around to the near side. And it'll go all the way down. Skinner picks up. 40 seconds left on the man advantage. Skinner carries into the zone, leaves off to the far side, and Ness. Ness is met there. Puck squirts free. It gets caught in the referee's skates on Buchholz. Buchholz keeps alive, though. Now he's stepped into, and it's sent all the way down. Ahead for Russell. This is Gower. Taken away and thrown all the way down. Cats come full strength. 1:06 left to go here in the period. 5 minutes to play in the first period. This is Buchholz. Gains the line, hits the brakes, dumps it deep for Russell. Cats take it away though, and now Granis looks to attack. He dumps it in. Around to the near side. Dahlin. He finds Bjorgi. Bjorgi dumps it deep. Miller out of his net to stop. Thrown to the near side. Granis finds it. Plays ahead for Rodna. Loose puck. Klein finds it in neutral ice. Gains the line. Has it poked free by Peterson. Peterson around to the far side. Bjorgi. Banks ahead. He missed Westland. It's out to neutral. Final 15 seconds. Klein backpedaling. Quickly up ice for Rodna. Finds Granis. Granis looking back for Rodna. It's broken up. Bar 2 trying to just take it into the corner and eat the final 5 seconds. Spun around to the near side. Stauber pinching down. Pokes it deep in the horn sounds to end the first. We're through one. Toros trail the Bobcats by a score of 2-1. We will take a commercial break. Come back with more here on the Minotauros Network after these messages.
Hi, Toro fans. Kyler Clavin here to tell you hockey can be rough, and so can driving in North Dakota winter. If you have an accident, bring your car or truck to Minot's Finest Collision Center. Corey and his staff are clearly Minot's Finest. Call them at 701-839-0989. Minot's Finest Collision Center. They are really Minot's Finest.
What's the best birthday party option in town? Toro's Hockey. You supply the birthday boy or girl, and the Toros do the rest. Designated party areas, and all sorts of perks to make your birthday kid feel special on his or her special day. Kids, it's up to you. Tell your parents or guardian that you want to celebrate your birthday with Tank and the Toros. For more information, call 701-852-0101 or visit MinotaurosHockey.com. Toros Hockey, making your birthday special. Join the charge.
Take care of your feet, and they'll take care of you. The foot and ankle specialists at Trinity Health can help with both surgical and non-surgical solutions. So, patients who suffer from foot and ankle-related issues can say, so long heel pain, catch you later corns, hasta la vista hammer toes. Relieve pain now and help prevent future discomfort. Diagnosis and treatment is available today. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. When I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line of that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
Captain's Cove Seafood Restaurant invites you in for your favorite seafood as well as steak, chicken, and lots of great burgers and sandwiches. The Cove has fish and chips, crab, shrimp, and all-you-can-eat meals. Captain's Cove, where fishing is made easy. 1735 South Broadway in Minot.
Throughout the areas we serve, First International Bank and Trust employees are actively involved in helping our customers and communities grow. This is Kevin Vigestead from First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Whether it's coaching a Little League team, leading through involvement with nonprofit organizations, or a proud Beaver booster, know that all of us at First International Bank and Trust are committed to giving back to the places where we live and work.
His wife's words echoed in his mind.
You never fix anything around here.
Well, today that would change. He would fix the water heater. He'd show her that he was the handyman of this house. He was more than capable. Oh, no. Covered it. August 14th, 2008. Talk to farmers. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Underwritten by Farmers Truck Fire Insurance Exchanges and Affiliates. Products not available in every state.
Hey, Toro fans. Ken Oda here. Whether you need to insure your auto, home, or life, call the Miranda Schuler Farmers Agency at 838-8144. Or better yet, do what I do and stop in. They keep free candy on their desks.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at LibertyTax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
I guess I don't have to tell you that I've been unsatisfied with your performance lately. You're showing your age. I think I even see a bald spot. It's time for Tires Plus.
Tires Plus has the prescription to satisfy all your vehicle needs, from tires to repair. Stop settling for average performance. Trust your locally owned Tires Plus. Some common side effects may occur, such as family safety, feelings of happiness, strange smiles that last all day, free courtesy rides, and raccoon hands. Actually, that's not real. I was just checking to see if you're listening. Thinking tires, think Tires Plus.
The Job Connection, brought to you by Classic Hits 1390 KRRZ.
Coulter Energy is hiring day supervisors, night operators, and field assistants. Must be able to pass a drug and alcohol test along with a physical. Must be able to work away from home in extended hours. Coulter Energy offers competitive wages, including drive time wage and non-taxable per diem, and benefits. Send resume to jobs at coulterenergy.ca or online at coulterenergy.com. Coulter Energy is an equal opportunity employer.
For info about this job and others, head to classichits1390.com.
Toros fans, Toros goalie Ben Garrity here. You don't have to stop a 100-mile-an-hour slap shot to make big saves like me. Download Fan Saves, the free mobile app on Apple and Android, and save big bucks all around town at Toros Partners. Places like Mattress Firm, Two Dark Motorsports, Applebee's, Qdoba, and Magic City Hoagies all give you ways to save. So download Fan Saves today and save money all around Minot just for being a Toro fan.
Your hands are a vital part of who you are, how you work, play, even how you communicate. When injury or illness strikes, the hand team at Trinity Health will be there to help restore full functionality. We specialize in surgical repairs, hand reconstruction, non-surgical interventions, and occupational therapies. Don't let damage or disorder take away your hands. See the hand team at Trinity Health. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
What's the best birthday party option in town? Toros Hockey. You supply the birthday boy or girl, and the Toros do the rest. Designated party areas and all sorts of perks to make your birthday kid feel special on his or her special day. Kids, it's up to you. Tell your parents or guardian that you want to celebrate your birthday with Tank and the Toros. For more information, call 701-852-0101 or visit MinnetoRosHockey.com. Toros Hockey, making your birthday special. Join the charge.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena. Toros trail the Bobcats by a score of 2-1 through 20 minutes of play. We'll recap it all for you, as well as take a spin around the rest of the hockey world. The college hockey scoreboard as well. Just one game last night, so we didn't really look at it, but it was Colgate and Tyler Jeanson and John Snodgrass were visiting Ohio State. Ohio State got the win, along with former Toro Matt Jennings. Tyler Jeanson did have one of the goals for Colgate in the 3-2 loss. Here tonight, Toros trail 2-1. The Cats jumped out to an early lead, 5:16 in. Willie Stauber from Grannis. For Stauber, was his third of the season. Grannis is ninth helper. At 8:35, Hunter Olsen got his third of the season from Stauber, seventh helper, and Schwartz, his eighth. Then at 11:46 of the first, Sam Skinner completed a 2-on-1 with Jay Buchholz to get the Toros back in it. And it looks like we've got Nick Charchenko on the bench, so we're going to turn you over to the PA.
Coming to you live on the Toros bench, it's the Farmers Union intermission interview. Joining me on the bench is defenseman Nikolai Charchenko. Nikolai, just coming off Christmas break, what did you do for the holidays?
Yeah, so I went home to my Minnesota and spent time with family, friends, and had Christmas both sides of the family. It was a pretty fun time.
What was your favorite gift you got this year?
I actually got a red and maroon Toro suit jacket that I wore to the rink. It's pretty nice.
Nice. We'll have to get you a picture and post it on Twitter here. All right, real quick, I want you to hold up this jersey. First off, have you ever done any modeling before?
I have, yes, actually.
All right, then I picked the right guy. Fans, this jersey that Nikolai is holding will be given away to the first 800 fans in attendance on January 3rd if you bring two non-perishable food items or $10. If you do that, you walk out of here with this jersey. All donations will go to the Great Plains Food Bank. So, what do you think of the jersey?
It's a pretty nice jersey. I mean, not going to lie.
All right, final question here on the Farmers Union Intermission Interview. We did, at the beginning of the year, Toros Meeting Toros, and we talked about how you were in a robotics club and all that. So, obviously, you're a pretty smart guy. So, let me ask you this really simple question. If you have a diesel bus, do you put regular gasoline in it?
No, I don't know what Bismarck's doing, but I'll shut the engine down.
All right, there you have it, fans. That's your Farmers Union Intermission Interview.
That was Peter Theodos with Nikolai Charchenko on the Toro bench. Taking a look at the out-of-town scoreboard, Austin up 6-1 on the Minnesota Wilderness. Through two periods, the Minnesota Magicians trail the Chippewa Steel 4-2. Topeka up 3-2 on Shreveport in the second. And that's it for the North American Hockey League. Looking at the college scoreboard, Sacred Heart up 4-0 on Bentley. Actually, that's a final. 5-2, Canisius over Holy Cross. That's a final as well. About to go final, Quinnipiac a 3-1 lead on Princeton. Ohio State shuts out Colgate 3-0. It took overtime for them to finish in a tie. UConn and St. Lawrence at deuces. Providence 2-1 over Lake State. That's a final, as is St. Cloud State over Minnesota State 7-2. Harvard upends Arizona State 7-1. Johnny Walker not in on the lone goal for Arizona. Dartmouth 4-2 over Colorado College. Vermont 1-0 over Union. Bemidji State and Minnesota are starting the third tied at 2. UND has an exhibition game with the Team USA U18s. That gets going later tonight. We'll skip most of the AHL board, but we're looking for games that feature Toro alum, and it looks like they're all West Coast games. Stockton's at Bakersfield. And, oh, actually, that's done. Wilkes-Barre finishes a 2-1 victory over the Hershey Bears. John Lazotte for Wilkes-Barre finished the game with 3 shots and even. Looking at the NHL scoreboard, heading into overtime, looks like. 1:05 left between the Stars and Avs. Rangers 4-3 over the Maple Leafs. That is late third. 5-3, Lightning over Canadiens. That one is in the third. Late third as well. The Panthers lead the Red Wings 5-4. Predators and Penguins 4-4 late in the third. 1:17 left to play in Carolina, where the Hurricanes lead the Capitals 6-3. Not yet underway. Kings at Nucks, Yotes at Knights, and Flyers at Sharks. We will take another commercial break, come back with the second period after these messages here on the Minotauros Network.
Hi, Toro fans. Kyler Clevin here to tell you hockey can be rough, and so can driving in North Dakota winter. If you have an accident, bring your car or truck to Minot's Finest Collision Center. Corey and his staff are clearly Minot's Finest. Call them at 701-839-0989. Minot's Finest Collision Center. They are really Minot's Finest.
What's the best birthday party option in town? Toro's Hockey.
You supply the birthday boy or girl, and the Toros do the rest. Designated party areas, and all sorts of perks to make your birthday kid feel special on his or her special day. Kids, it's up to you. Tell your parents or guardian that you want to celebrate your birthday with Tank and the Toros. For more information, call 701-852-0101 or visit Minnetoroshockey.com. Toros Hockey, making your birthday special. Join the charge.
Take care of your feet, and they'll take care of you. The foot and ankle specialists at Trinity Health can help with both surgical and non-surgical solutions. So, patients who suffer from foot and ankle-related issues can say, so long heel pain, catch you later corns, hasta la vista hammer toes. Relieve pain now and help prevent future discomfort. Diagnosis and treatment is available today. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. When I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line of that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
Captain's Cove Seafood Restaurant invites you in for your favorite seafood as well as steak, chicken, and lots of great burgers and sandwiches. The Cove has fish and chips, crab, shrimp, and all-you-can-eat meals. Captain's Cove, where fishing is made easy. 1735 South Broadway in Minot.
Throughout the areas we serve, First International Bank and Trust employees are actively involved in helping our customers and communities grow. This is Kevin Vigestead from First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Whether it's coaching a Little League team, leading through involvement with nonprofit organizations, or a proud Beaver booster, know that all of us at First International Bank and Trust are committed to giving back to the places where we live and work.
His wife's words echoed in his mind.
You never fix anything around here.
Well, today that would change. He would fix the water heater. He'd show her that he was the handyman of this house. He was more than capable. Oh, no. Covered it. August 14th, 2008. Talk to farmers. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Underwritten by Farmers Truck Fire Insurance Exchanges and Affiliates. Products not available in every state.
Hey, Toro fans. Ken Oda here. Whether you need to insure your auto, home, or life, call the Miranda Schuler Farmers Agency at 838-8144. Or better yet, do what I do and stop in. They keep free candy on their desks.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at LibertyTax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
I guess I don't have to tell you that I've been unsatisfied with your performance lately. You're showing your age. I think I even see a bald spot. It's time for Tires Plus.
Tires Plus has the prescription to satisfy all your vehicle needs, from tires to repair. Stop settling for average performance. Trust your locally owned Tires Plus. Some common side effects may occur, such as family safety, feelings of happiness, strange smiles that last all day, free courtesy rides, and raccoon hands. Actually, that's not real. I was just checking to see if you're listening. Thinking tires, think Tires Plus.
The Job Connection, brought to you by Classic Hits 1390 KRRZ.
Coulter Energy is hiring day supervisors, night operators, and field assistants. Must be able to pass a drug and alcohol test along with a physical. Must be able to work away from home in extended hours. Coulter Energy offers competitive wages, including drive time wage and non-taxable per diem, and benefits. Send resume to jobs at coulterenergy.ca or online at coulterenergy.com. Coulter Energy is an equal opportunity employer.
For info about this job and others, head to ClassicHits1390.com.
Toros fans, Toros goalie Ben Garrity here. You don't have to stop a 100-mile-an-hour slap shot to make big saves like me. Download FanSaves, the free mobile app on Apple and Android, and save big bucks all around town at Toros Partners. Places like Mattress Firm, Two Dark Motorsports, Applebee's, Qdoba, and Magic City Hoagies all give you ways to save. So download FanSaves today and save money all around Minot just for being a Toro fan.
Your hands are a vital part of who you are, how you work, play, even how you communicate. When injury or illness strikes, the hand team at Trinity Health will be there to help restore full functionality. We specialize in surgical repairs, hand reconstruction, non-surgical interventions, and occupational therapies. Don't let damage or disorder take away your hands. See the hand team at Trinity Health. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
What's the best birthday party option in town? Toro's Hockey. You supply the birthday boy or girl, and the Toros do the rest. Designated party areas and all sorts of perks to make your birthday kid feel special on his or her special day. Kids, it's up to you. Tell your parents or guardian that you want to celebrate your birthday with Tank and the Toros. For more information, call 701-852-0101 or visit Minnetoroshockey.com. Toros Hockey, making your birthday special. Join the charge.
Applebee's 2 for $20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Hi, Toro fans. Kyler Clevin here to tell you hockey can be rough, and so can driving in North Dakota winter. If you have an accident, bring your car or truck to Minot's Finest Collision Center. Corey and his staff are clearly Minot's Finest. Call them at 701-839-0989. Minot's Finest Collision Center. They are really Minot's Finest.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. When I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line to that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
His wife's words echoed in his mind.
You never fix anything around here.
Well, today that would change. He would fix the water heater. He'd show her that he was the handyman of this house. He was more than capable. Oh, no. Covered it. August 14th, 2008. Talk to farmers. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Underwritten by Farmers, Truck, Fire Insurance, Exchanges, and Affiliates. Products not available in every state.
Hey, Toro fans. Ken Oda here. Whether you need to insure your auto, home, or life, call the Miranda Schuler Farmers Agency at 838-8144. Or better yet, do what I do and stop in. They keep free candy on their desks.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena as we get you ready to start period number two between the Toros and the Bismarck Bobcats. Bobcats lead the Toros 2-0, or 2-1, sorry. Far side, dumped in. Miller has it bounced to the side of his net. Moved around to the near side, Marty. Toros working to the front, quick shot, gloved and held by Miller. Draw will be in the offensive zone to the right side of Miller. Imminent line against the Johnson line. Skinner with a shot that's blocked into the corner. Imminent trying to get it to the front for Armstrong Kincaid. Armstrong Kincaid fights through and keeps it alive. Quick shot in and out of the glove. Imminent finds it. Tries to get it back to the front. It doesn't get through. All the way down it goes into the Toro zone. Skinner sweeps it along to the near side, and Stibbe, it's cut off though. Skinner takes it back. Skinner pushing play into the offensive zone. He's got Stibbe with him, tries a shot. It's gloved and held for a whistle. 19:01 left to go here in period number two. Toro still trail 2-1 despite out shooting the Bobcats 12-8. Buchholz on the draw against Hillman. Buchholz wins it sideways, but Martell takes it away from Clevin. Far side, Schwartz was way short of center when he touched that, but apparently it was close enough to negate an icing. Wasberg works a man over in the corner. Kroll steps in to help as well. They dig along the wall, and Kroll comes out with it. Kroll gives to Russell, quickly up ice. Clevin gives to Buchholz. Buchholz in for Clevin. Quick shot. That goes off the tip of the glove. Near side, Kroll throws one on net. That gets tipped wide. Wasberg pinches down, keeps it alive. Buchholz there to help. Buchholz pinned to the wall. Three on three. They battle along the boards. And then it's thrown in behind the Bobcat net. Stauber's there first. He makes a move to get it out to neutral. It's played to the Toro line. Now quickly ahead, Clevin. He's got Russell with him. Clevin for Russell. Shot. Save made by Miller. Clevin on his backhand, turning to the forehand, has his shot blocked to the far side corner. Schwartz has it taken away by Clevin. Clevin trying to bank it back to the defense. It's poked up into the Bobcat bench. For a whistle, 17:45 left to go here in the second. Two one our score here. 17:45 left to go here in period number two. Toro's trail. Now Jacob Marty walks in, wires that one goes. Where is it? It must have gone up and out of play.
Jimmy John's bringing that puck out of play. Jimmy John's freaky fast delivery.
I don't see where it went. Draw to the right of Garrity. Toros control it. This is Westland chipping it deep, looking to chase it down against Magnuson. Cats win the battle in the corner, and Magnuson looks up ice. Jopi chips it deep. Skinner's the first to it, guides it around to the near side. Only Jacob Marty is there, however. Played in behind the net. Cats trying to get it to the front. It hits a leg and carries to Pekowski on the near side half wall. He turns back the way he came, gets bumped off by Bartu. They try to work it to the front. It's cut off, shot off the leg pad and then the pipe. Pekowski tries to throw it down low for Jopi. It's off the mark. Skinner finds it. He's met behind the cage. Toros start up ice. This is Bartu. He's got Dahlin with him. Bartu leaves for Westland. His shot goes wide to the far side corner. Kept at the point by Charchenko. This is Hargindagi finding a loose puck. Carrying it deep. Jojo leaves for Charchenko. Charchenko shot, save made, rebound. OC couldn't get it to go. Oh my, what a save by Miller. He's been huge this period. Hacked up the wall and it ends up out in neutral. Toros dump it in. Ness touches up and now looks to pursue. He steps into Magnuson to the delight of the home faithful. Kroll and Granis do battle. Support comes from Wasberg. He starts Ness up ice. Ness into the zone, leaves for Hargindagi. Hargindagi's shot's blocked, and it caroms to the far side corner. O'Connell looks to put it deep for Ness, but it's taken away by the Bobcats. This is into the corner. Cats working in the slot, played back to the point, long shot blocked out front into the corner. Hargindagi finds it. Ness tied up along the wall, comes out with it. Does Ness comes across for Kroll. Kral, long pass ahead, finds Hargindagi. JoJo tied up by a pair of Bobcats. Support comes from Ness. I'm sorry, that's imminent. 18, not 19. Back to Peterson. He just banks one in behind the net. Jack Olson's on it first. Quickly ahead. Hillman into the zone. His shot's blocked. Swept around to the far side. Schwartz punches it deep for Hillman. Hillman walking out of the corner on his backhand. Turning back the way he came. They dig in the near side corner. It squirts free, and it's picked up by Bjorgi. Three on three as the Toros go the other way. Bjorgi was short of center. They'll wave off the icing. Toros finally catch a break. This is Stibbe out of the corner. Back to the point in Charchenko. Long shot. That goes just wide. Armstrong Kincaid down the wall. Imminent. Can't hold on, and it's thrown out to neutral. Charchenko's on it first. Left for Skinner. Quickly up. He has Buchholz. Buchholz leaves for Armstrong Kincaid. Armstrong Kincaid and Buchholz trying to work out of the corner against a trio of Bobcats. Armstrong Kincaid back to the point. Skinner holding there. Shot looking for a tip from Buchholz, who was on his knees. Clevin working down low. Plays it back to the point in Skinner. Skinner sweeps across for Charchenko. Charchenko punches it down low. He wanted Clevin. It didn't get there. Hunter Olsen throws out to neutral. Won't go far enough for icing, so the Toros have to play. Quick up on the near side. Russell carries into the zone. Looks to leave for Buchholz. Doesn't get there. Clevin finds it. Can't quite stick a fork in it, however, and Pekowski tries the far side, and Jopie. Jopie tries a shot save made by Garrity. Rebound to the near side. Buchholz looks to settle it down. Wasberg up the far side along the benches as it come back to the Toro zone, and Kral. Kral pressured, plays to the far side. It's quickly ahead for Clevin. Wasberg makes a nice move, gains the line, tries a shot, save made, no rebound given. Draw will be to the left of Miller, Bar 2, and Grant Johnson. This is Westland with a shot. Tibbetts in. Westland throws one on net. And finds Twine. Westland with a flipper. Unless it was tipped out front, I don't think it was. Nope, they say Westland from bar two. Pass up ice. That just misses bar two. So we're all even up. Big hit by Peterson on Schwartz, but Hillman going the other way. They dig in the near corner. Far side. Bjorgi. Glass and not out for the Toros. Now they do get it out, but Jopie's right back in. Poked back out to neutral once again. This is Garrity playing to the far side. Dolan's able to touch out to neutral. Klein's on it there. Long pass up. Good stick by Peterson. Denies that chance. And now he just hoists one out to neutral. Into the zone for the catch. Jopie comes across for Marty. Marty shot off the pipe. Up top for Klein. Shot blocked by Hargindigi. Flicked ahead. It won't get to Hargindigi. Ness finds it though and speeds into the zone. Ness. Nice poke by Stauber to take that away. And now Marty on the near side plays ahead for Pekowski. Pekowski gives to Jopie. Jopie back to Pekowski. Pekowski turns it over to O'Connell, the Toro captain. Keeps it alive for Ness. Ness into the zone. Looking for the trailer, Skinner. Skinner delays. His shot's blocked. Skinner finds it. Holds in the corner. Puck hack to the near side. Jacob Marty looks across for Jopie. Back into the middle. Pekowski with a backhander. That's gobbled up by Garrity. 10-10 left to play here in the second. We're all even at deuces. Thanks to Westland's seventh of the season. We've got our media timeout. We will take one, too. When we come back, we'll have the rest of period number two right here on the Minotauros Network.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at libertytax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena. Toros and Bobcats even at deuces. Quick shot, that's blocked up and over. Kroll finds it. In behind the net, guides it around to the near side. Wasberg hoists ahead. Martel can't keep it away from Immonen, and then Immonen taken down. No call. Toros battle for it on the near side. Stibbe wins it back to Kroll. Kroll shot. Save made by Miller. I think Immonen may have redirected that slightly. This is Johnson chipping it into the Toro zone. Kroll will be the first to it, though. Guides it around to the near side and Stibbe. Stibbe leaves it back for Kroll. Kroll back to Stibbe. Starts Immonen up ice. Immonen gains the line and leaves off for Armstrong Kincaid. Quick shot. That's blocked. In behind, Toros might be caught in a change with the defenseman. No. Good work by the forwards to prevent a rush the other way. Peterson now just hoisted into the corner. Martel will be the first to it. And on the touch, the whistle goes. It's a trip. And I think the Toros are headed to the power play. Maybe. Yes. Rodna. Toros 0 for 2 on the power play, about to get their third opportunity. Cats have yet to have one tonight. Draw to the right of Miller. Toros control. Skinner looking for a lane, leaves off far side. Russell, quick shot. That hits the mask, and now Clevin tip. Doesn't go for Ness. A nifty redirect almost between his own legs. Well, it went between his own legs, but it didn't quite go past the goaltender. Toros play catch on the near side now. It's Clevin. Clevin looks across for Russell. Russell shot up and over with help from the goaltender's blocker. This is Russell. Russell into the corner. Buchholz up top for Clevin. Back to Buchholz. Up top, Skinner. Leaves off far side, Russell. Russell fans on the shot, and the Toros have to chase. 8:25 left to go here in period number two. 108 left on the man advantage. Skinner starts up ice. Leaves it back, and now the Toros Stibbe gains the line on the far side, only to lose the puck to Klein. Good hit on the far side, keeps it alive. Kroll. Leaves off for Stibbe. Stibbe walks in, wires. That one goes up and over. Imminent. Can't stop the rebound, and the Toros have to regroup in neutral with 39 seconds left on the power play. Toros are into the zone, but it's punched right back out. Twenty-five seconds on the man advantage. Kroll holds behind the Toros net. Ahead for Dahlin. Gains the line, and that is offside. 14 seconds left on the Toro power play. Draw will be in the neutral zone. Draw will be. In front of the Toro penalty box, Hargindigi and Jopi, a pair of eights. Toro's out shooting the Bobcats 20-15, but we're tied at two aside. This is Peterson. Jorgi serpentines through the neutral zone, then dumps one in. Miller stops that behind the net. Throws it to the near side, and Jopi. Cats are full strength. Jopi trying to drive the net. Puts one off the outside of the cage. The Toros will look to turn it. This is Hargindigi. Jojo speeds up the near side. Peterson there in support. Keeps it in the zone. Turnaround shot blocked. Westland hammers. Hargindigi with a backhand try. That didn't get through either. Jorgi flips one in behind the net. Jojo working there, trying to get it to the front. He can't do so. Now the Cats try to go the other way. Jopi with speed. Gains the line, comes across for Rodna. Shot, it's in. Rodna. So Rodna strikes for his 11th of the season. And now the Cats are back on the attack. Centering feed broken up, and now the Toros look to turn. Klevin gives to Russell, back to Klevin. Spins it to the front, it didn't get through to Charchenko. Buchholz shot. Comes off the glass, and then Miller turns to glove it as it comes back the way it came. Oh. Offensive zone draw for the Toros. This is Klein. Behind his own net, getting harassed by Klevin. Now he plays up the middle for Hillman. Far side, Skinner hacks it away. And chops it into the bench. Gower and Jopi with the assists. Hillman and Stibbe on the draw. Didn't go. Cats control, but it's taken away by Immonen. Immonen gains the line, tries to leave off for Armstrong Kincaid. He's getting hooked and held the entire way. Klein snapped his head back, trying to draw a call, didn't get one, and now Skinner pressuring. Skins leaves off for Armstrong Kincaid. He's wiped out on the far side. Gets it back, though, as Stauber holds on to him. Far side, Hillman. comes across. That's blocked off. Stibbe can't find it. Long shot from Irie goes wide. Touched out for Stibbe. Working one on two. Stibbe will just dump it deep and peel off to change. Ness pokes it free. Near side, crawl down the wall. Didn't work, and now Jacob Marty going the other way. Wasberg gets back and cleans that up nicely. Crawl ahead for Hargindagi. Didn't get it, and it'll go for an icing. A palindrome on the clock. 4:44 left to play here in period number two. The Toros trail the Cats 3-2. Draw in the defensive zone for the Toros after the icing. Icing's brought to you by Minot's Finest Collision Center. Bouncing puck. Eventually controlled by Ness. Ness speeds ahead. Crisscrosses with Hargindagi. Then Ness carries into the near side wall. Around behind the net. Ness using his body to protect. Now he's in the scrum. Can he walk to the front? Ness delays, one-timer, and O'Connell had the whole net and just missed it. Meanwhile, Gower was tied up with Hargindagi, and the Toros will go to the power play again. And Gower's letting Burns have it. So the Toros get their fourth power play of the game. I think they called this a 2 and a 10. I'm not sure, though. I think it's a rough and an unsportsmanlike. Still waiting for an explanation. It is a 2 and a 10. Looks like, yeah, it is a 2 and a 10. So the Toros back to the power play. Buchholz, Ness, Russell, Clevin, and Skinner. The five out for the Toros. Skinner leaves for Russell. Down low for Ness. Finds Clevin. Shot in and out of the glove. Buchholz throws it across the blue paint. No one home on a tip. Skinner leaves off far side. Russell again. Clevin up top for Skinner. Skinner holding. Shot. Blocked out front by traffic and then cleared. 125 on the man advantage. Toros start up ice. 117 on the power play. This is Skinner. Carries into the zone and rings it around to the far side. Buchholz moves it to Russell. Russell down for Ness. Ness to the hash marks. Up top for Clevin. Touches for Skinner. Back to Clevin. Back to Skinner. Far side, Russell. Banks in behind for Buchholz. Gives to Clevin. Clevin back to Buchholz. Up top for Clevin. Clevin looking for a lane. His shot's blocked and poked out to neutral by Hillman. Toros control, 34 seconds on the power play as they finish their change. Stibbe will come up ice with 28. Stibbe finds O'Connell. OC gains the line and leaves for Stibbe. Stibbe lost the handle, and the Cats find it and clear out to neutral. Kroll. Forced all the way down the ice by Granis. And then gets tackled from behind. Toros want a call, but I can't imagine they're going to get many more favors from the official. They've got the game only five. Oh, there's another one. But the, just as they come full strength, they call. Klein. So with 2:09 left in the second, the Toros will get their sixth power play of the game. Another fifth power play of the game. Jaw will be to the left of Miller. Toro's control. This is Kroll. Looking for space. Tries a shot. It's blocked out front by Stauber. Hargindigi can't get to the front. The Bobcats clear. This is Kroll. Hargindigi carries ahead. Lost the handle, and it's poked out to neutral. Kroll with it. Gains the line. Looks for space. Gives down to Dahlin. Dahlin banks back to Kroll. Kroll comes across for Wasberg. Back for Dahlin on the far side. Up top, Wasberg, one-timer. Where was it? It got blocked out front and cleared the length. Minute 5 on the power play. Ness with Russell Buchholz. Final minute of play in the period. Russell for Buchholz on the far side. Toros gain the line. Good keep by Russell, only for a moment as it's punched back out. Buchholz comes across for Skinner into the zone. Skinner has it poked free. Buchholz is there. Buchholz down low for Ness. Ness has it stripped away. He gets it back though, does Ness. Ness comes out, tries to stuff it. It doesn't go. And then Ness gets tackled out front. For a whistle. By Stauber. 19 seconds left in the Toro power play. Draw will be to the right of Miller. Shots are 22-17 in favor of the Toros, but they trail 3-2. Toro's control. Kroll down low for Klevin. Up top. Across for Kroll. Kroll looking for a lane. Shot. Save made as Bismarck comes full strength. 5.8 left as Miller holds on. Draw will be to the left of Miller. Ness to take it for the Toros against Johnson. 5.8 seconds. Ness won it back, but the Toros couldn't find it. The Bobcats ice the puck, but the horn sounds to end the period. We are through two. Toros trail the Bobcats by a score of 3-2. We'll take a commercial break. Come back with more here on the Minotauros Network.
Hi, Toro fans. Kyler Clavin here to tell you hockey can be rough, and so can driving in North Dakota winter. If you have an accident, bring your car or truck to Minot's Finest Collision Center. Corey and his staff are clearly Minot's Finest. Call them at 701-839-0989. Minot's Finest Collision Center. They are really Minot's Finest.
What's the best birthday party option in town? Toro's Hockey. You supply the birthday boy or girl, and the Toros do the rest. Designated party areas, and all sorts of perks to make your birthday kid feel special on his or her special day. Kids, it's up to you. Tell your parents or guardian that you want to celebrate your birthday with Tank and the Toros. For more information, call 701-852-0101 or visit MinotaurosHockey.com. Toros Hockey, making your birthday special. Join the charge.
Take care of your feet, and they'll take care of you. The foot and ankle specialists at Trinity Health can help with both surgical and non-surgical solutions. So, patients who suffer from foot and ankle-related issues can say, so long heel pain, catch you later corns, hasta la vista hammer toes. Relieve pain now and help prevent future discomfort. Diagnosis and treatment is available today. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. When I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line of that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
Captain's Cove Seafood Restaurant invites you in for your favorite seafood as well as steak, chicken, and lots of great burgers and sandwiches. The Cove has fish and chips, crab, shrimp, and all-you-can-eat meals. Captain's Cove, where fishing is made easy. 1735 South Broadway in Minot.
Throughout the areas we serve, First International Bank and Trust employees are actively involved in helping our customers and communities grow. This is Kevin Vigestead from First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Whether it's coaching a Little League team, leading through involvement with nonprofit organizations, or a proud Beaver booster, know that all of us at First International Bank and Trust are committed to giving back to the places where we live and work.
His wife's words echoed in his mind.
You never fix anything around here.
Well, today that would change. He would fix the water heater. He'd show her that he was the handyman of this house. He was more than capable. Oh, no. Covered it. August 14th, 2008. Talk to farmers. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Underwritten by Farmers Truck Fire Insurance Exchanges and Affiliates. Products not available in every state.
Hey, Toro fans. Ken Oda here. Whether you need to insure your auto, home, or life, call the Miranda Schuler Farmers Agency at 838-8144. Or better yet, do what I do and stop in. They keep free candy on their desks.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at LibertyTax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
I guess I don't have to tell you that I've been unsatisfied with your performance lately. You're showing your age. I think I even see a bald spot. It's time for Tires Plus.
Tires Plus has the prescription to satisfy all your vehicle needs, from tires to repair. Stop settling for average performance. Trust your locally owned Tires Plus. Some common side effects may occur, such as family safety, feelings of happiness, strange smiles that last all day, free courtesy rides, and raccoon hands. Actually, that's not real. I was just checking to see if you're listening. Thinking tires, think Tires Plus.
The Job Connection, brought to you by Classic Hits 1390 KRRZ.
Coulter Energy is hiring day supervisors, night operators, and field assistants. Must be able to pass a drug and alcohol test along with a physical. Must be able to work away from home in extended hours. Coulter Energy offers competitive wages, including drive time wage and non-taxable per diem, and benefits. Send resume to jobs at coulterenergy.ca or online at coulterenergy.com. Coulter Energy is an equal opportunity employer.
For info about this job and others, head to classichits1390.com.
Toros fans, Toros goalie Ben Garrity here. You don't have to stop a 100-mile-an-hour slap shot to make big saves like me. Download FanSaves, the free mobile app on Apple and Android, and save big bucks all around town at Toros Partners. Places like Mattress Firm, Two Dark Motorsports, Applebee's, Qdoba, and Magic City Hoagies all give you ways to save. So download FanSaves today and save money all around Minot just for being a Toro fan.
Your hands are a vital part of who you are, how you work, play, even how you communicate. When injury or illness strikes, the hand team at Trinity Health will be there to help restore full functionality. We specialize in surgical repairs, hand reconstruction, non-surgical interventions, and occupational therapies. Don't let damage or disorder take away your hands. See the hand team at Trinity Health. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
What's the best birthday party option in town? Toros Hockey. You supply the birthday boy or girl, and the Toros do the rest. Designated party areas and all sorts of perks to make your birthday kid feel special on his or her special day. Kids, it's up to you. Tell your parents or guardian that you want to celebrate your birthday with Tank and the Toros. For more information, call 701-852-0101 or visit MinnetoTorosHockey.com. Toros Hockey, making your birthday special. Join the charge.
Applebee's 2 for $20. Now that's eating good in the neighborhood.
Hi, Toro fans. Kyler Clavin here to tell you hockey can be rough, and so can driving in North Dakota winter. If you have an accident, bring your car or truck to Minot's Finest Collision Center. Corey and his staff are clearly Minot's Finest. Call them at 701-839-0989. Minot's Finest Collision Center. They are really Minot's Finest.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena. We're going to take it down to the ice for the Farmers Union interview.
An intermission interview. Joining me on the bench for this interview is Jake Westland. Jack, excuse me. So, Jack, what was your holiday? What did you do over the holiday breaks this year?
Just had Christmas with my grandma and grandpa, and then I had another Christmas with just my mom, dad, and my siblings. So,
all right, your favorite all-time gift? Someone just made a really good toss, by the way. This year and of all time.
This year I got a pretty nice sweatshirt for my mom. That was probably my favorite. And then favorite gift of all time is probably my Xbox.
All right. We got a jersey right here, so hold that up. Have you ever done any modeling before?
Yeah, a few times. Hand model.
Hand modeling. All right. Once again, fans, January 3rd, that's next Saturday, or Friday, excuse me, you can walk out of the Mesa Arena with this jersey once the Zamboni goes by. Shout out Brandon McFall. You can get this jersey if you bring two non-perishable food items or $10 to the Mesa Arena. Once again, the donations will go to the Great Plains Food Bank, so you can walk out with a pretty nice jersey. What do you think?
Yeah, it's super nice.
All right, that's your Farmers Union intermission interview. Fans, make sure you continue to make some noise. We need this place rocking.
That was Jack Westland on the bench with Peter Theodos. Thank you to Peter for talking to Westy. He had the Toros goal in the second period. Not enough so far, though. Toros still trail 3-2. In the first, it was Stauber from Granis at 5:16 to make it 1-0 Bismarck. Hunter Olsen at 8:35 got his third of the season from Stauber and Schwartz. That made it 2-0 Cats. Sam Skinner from Buchholz at 11:46 got the Toros on the board. Had the Toros down 2-1 after one. Toros tied it for a bit, 7:42 into the second. Westland from Bartu, his seventh of the season for Westy, his seventh helper for Bartu. Made it 2-2, but at 13:26, Lars Christian Rodney. Rodna, I should say, from Gower and Jopi restored the Bobcat lead. Toros are 0-5 on the power play, and if they don't come back in this one, that's going to be the number that haunts you. Five power plays, no power play goals. The Cats haven't had a power play tonight. So special teams, potential killer if the Toros don't come back in this one. Austin up 7-1 now on the Wilderness. That one's just about to go final. Also about to go final, Chippewa 6-4 over the Magicians. Late in the third, 7:07 to play, in fact. Topeka leads Shreveport 3-2. College hockey scoreboard, pretty much everything a final now. Sacred Heart 4-0 over Bentley. Canisius 5-2 over Holy Cross. Let's see if Lincoln Earn posted any numbers in that one. It looks like Link didn't dress. Quinnipiac 3-1 over Princeton. Ohio State 3-0 over Colgate. Take a peek at that box score. See if any of the three Toro alum in that one found their way onto the score sheet. We know Snodgrass and Jeanson did not. But perhaps Matt Jennings. Box score not loading for us, so we'll skip that. St. Lawrence and UConn finishing a 2-2 draw. Providence wins 2-1 over Lake State in overtime. St. Cloud didn't need overtime as they beat Minnesota State. Mankato 7-2. Harvard 4-1 over Arizona State. Dartmouth 5-2 over CC. Vermont 2-0 over Union. And Minnesota 5-2 over Bemidji. And UND 3-1 over the USA 18s in an exhibition game. NHL scores. The Canucks lead Blake Lizotte and the LA Kings 1-0. The Golden Knights 1-0 over the Coyotes. Both of those in the first, not yet underway. Flyers at Sharks. Final in a shootout, 3-2. Stars over the Avs. It took overtime, but the Rangers beat the Leafs 5-4. Lightning 5-4 over the Canadiens in regulation. Same score, Panthers over the Wings in regulation. 6-4, the Penguins top the Preds, and the same score for the Hurricanes, 6-4 over the Capitals. Here again, it is 3-2 in favor of Bismarck. We're going to send you out to commercial. We'll bring it back for the Chuck-a-Puck shots. See if we can give away some money here on the Minotauros Network.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. When I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line of that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
His wife's words echoed in his mind.
You never fix anything around here.
Well, today that would change. He would fix the water heater. He'd show her that he was the handyman of this house. He was more than capable. Oh, no. Covered it. August 14th, 2008. Talk to farmers. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Underwritten by Farmers Truck Fire Insurance Exchanges and Affiliates. Products not available in every state.
Hey, Toro fans. Ken Oda here. Whether you need to insure your auto, home, or life, call the Miranda Schuler Farmers Agency at 838-8144. Or better yet, do what I do and stop in. They keep free candy on their desks.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at libertytax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hello, I'm Steve Funningsland, consumer lender at First Western Bank and Trust and sports enthusiast. Employees at First Western know the importance of teamwork in their day-to-day banking duties to best serve the community. I know the Minot and surrounding area high school and college athletic teams know the importance of teamwork as well. We want to wish all local teams good luck in their athletic endeavors this year. Stay safe on the courts, on the fields, on the rinks, and in the gyms. We look forward to watching you succeed. With familiar faces you know, who know you by name, First Western Bank and Trust, you can bank on us, member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
All in one place, you can get a fabulous coffee, the best burger in town, arrange a meeting for up to 30 people, and begin your next trip, whether business or vacation. It's Minot's newest, most architecturally beautiful, versatile structure, the Minot International Airport. The Trestle Tap House and Cafe with Caribou Coffee and customizable meeting spaces are just a couple of the amenities offered. The Minot International Airport. See the world from home.
Toros fans, Toros goalie Ben Garrity here. You don't have to stop a 100-mile-an-hour slap shot to make big saves like me. Download Fan Saves, the free mobile app on Apple and Android, and save big bucks all around town at Toros Partners. Places like Mattress Firm, Two Dark Motorsports, Applebee's, Qdoba, and Magic City Hoagies all give you ways to save. So download Fan Saves today and save money all around Minot just for being a Toro fan.
Hi, this is Dave Panko from First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender. We want to wish all student athletes good luck this season, and may the friendships you make and the lessons you learn last a lifetime. At First International Bank and Trust, we're more than a bank. We're a family, a partner in the community where we live and work. Good luck to all teams. First International Bank and Trust. Live first.
Power up your career with Gooseneck Implement, inviting you to join our team at any one of our 13 John Deere dealerships in North and South Dakota. Gooseneck is now hiring for all positions, especially technicians. At Gooseneck Implement, we take pride in our family culture and our commitment to always reinvesting in our employees and our hometowns. To apply for a great job and invest in your future, visit GooseneckImplement.com. Proud to be your John Deere dealer. Gooseneck Implement, the power behind the paint.
Your hands are a vital part of who you are, how you work, play, even how you communicate. When injury or illness strikes, the hand team at Trinity Health will be there to help restore full functionality.
Gonna bring it back in. For the
chuck-a-putt shot.
Take it down to the ice.
Joining me on the ice for the shot is Mr.
Bill.
All right. Bill, I heard you had a birthday yesterday. Is that true?
Yep.
Bring it down a little bit?
All right, Mina, make some noise. Wish him a happy belated birthday here. All right, Bill, you're going to come over here to center ice. You're going to take three shots. Your first shot is worth $378. That's a bit to the left. Second shot, Bill, is for $189. That looks good. That was close. That was really close. All right, your third and final shot is for $95. That's going to be wide to the left. All right, Bill, you're still going to walk out of here with an oil change courtesy of Tires Plus. Congratulations and happy birthday.
That will do it for the Gooseneck Implement Intermission Show. We will send you back out to commercial. Come back with period number three after these messages here on the Minotauros Network.
Hi, Toro fans. Kyler Clavin here to tell you hockey can be rough, and so can driving in North Dakota winter. If you have an accident, bring your car or truck to Minot's Finest Collision Center. Corey and his staff are clearly Minot's Finest. Call them at 701-839-0989. Minot's Finest Collision Center. They are really Minot's Finest.
What's the best birthday party option in town? Toro's Hockey. You supply the birthday boy or girl, the Toros do the rest. Designated party areas and all sorts of perks to make your birthday kid feel special on his or her special day. Kids, it's up to you. Tell your parents or guardian that you want to celebrate your birthday with Tank and the Toros. For more information, call 701-852-0101 or visit MinotaurosHockey.com. Toros Hockey, making your birthday special. Join the charge.
Take care of your feet, and they'll take care of you. The foot and ankle specialists at Trinity Health can help with both surgical and non-surgical solutions. So, patients who suffer from foot and ankle-related issues can say, so long heel pain, catch you later corns, hasta la vista hammer toes. Relieve pain now and help prevent future discomfort. Diagnosis and treatment is available today. Trinity Health, reinventing health.
We live in such a fast-paced world. It's always go, go, go. When I'm out for a run, it's my time. It's the best way to start your day. Crossing the line of that marathon, it's the biggest reward you can get. I want my customers to achieve their goals and go above and beyond. I'm Nikki Ledeggi, and I'm one of the running experts at Shields.
Shields, when it comes to gear and expert advice, we're right there with you in Bismarck, Minot, Grand Forks, Fargo, and Moorhead.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena. We're getting you ready for the third period here on the Minotauros Network, AM 1390 KRZ and HockeyTV.com. Toros trail by a score of 3-2. Shots on goal, 23-17 in favor of the Toros. But again, it's 3-2 Bobcats. Toros have the game's only power plays, all five of them. But have been unable to cash in on any of them. That right now, the difference. Puck is dropped and we are underway in the third. Quick shot save made by Garrity. Rebound given. Jack Olson punches it deep. Flipped along the glass. Takes an awkward carom, but Immonen finds it and feeds Stibbe. Stibbe goes back to Immonen. Jacob Marty holds him off. This one's dumped in. Miller out of his net to stop it. Gives it to the far side and Jack Olson. Coming down the wall was Russell. He broke it up but couldn't find a handle on it. Out to neutral for Kroll. He'll dump it right back in. Stauber gives it to the far side. Out to neutral and Pekowski. Pekowski dumps it deep. Garrity out of his net. He'll stop it and leave for Wasberg. Kroll up the middle finds Buchholz. Buchholz in for Russell. Into the middle for Wasberg. Shot, it's in! Tie game! Wasberg, his first as a Toro. And we're all even. A nice play on the rush for the Toros. Wasberg goes five hole. Wasberg gloves down to the stick in his own zone. Here's the call, the goal.
Scoring his first goal as a Toro, number 72, Wilhelm Wasberg. for the assist to number 77, Will Kroll.
Give the helper to Kroll. And bar two. And Hillman on the draw to the right of Miller. Magnuson on it. Played to the far side, and it's sent all the way down. They'll say it was tipped by a Toro, so no icing. Around to the near side. Dahlin leaves for Bartu. Bartu speeds into the zone, looks to knife through, lost the handle. Can Dahlin get there? He cannot. Back out to neutral. Bartu. For Peterson. Bartu gives it up, gets it right back, and then carries deep into the zone. Bartu. Tied up behind the net. Dahlin's there. Dahlin. Back to the point. Charchenko. Shot blocked. It caroms to the side of the net. It's picked up there by Magnuson. Grannis working against Dahlin. Dahlin forcing him back and then takes it away. Dahlin to Charchenko. Dumps it down into the corner. Olsen ties up Westland. Ness has it poked free. Skinner dumps it back into the zone, delayed offside so the Toros couldn't chase it. Cats control. Magnuson, long pass picked off by Skinner. Skinner into the zone, drops a pass for Ness. Ness shot, it was partially blocked, and then blockered aside. Pajkowski goes down. Argindigi controls. Jojo leaves. Gets it right back. Quick shot. That's blocked to the far side half wall. Marty falls down. Takes it right back, though, after he gets up and looks to chase into the Toro zone. Pajkowski's shot's blocked. It comes back to him. Shot. I thought that went in, but apparently it hit the post. I was certain that went in, but it hit the post, I guess. Not much argument from the Bobcat bench, which, believe me, if there was an argument to be made, it would be coming. This is Hargindigi. He stood up, and a hungry, hungry hippo-style cover by Miller. So we're even at three aside here in the third. Shots on goal, 25-19. In favor of the Toros. Draw will be to the right of Miller. Immonen and Grant Johnson. Bobcats control. Fired out to neutral. Rodna looking to center for Jopi. It's blocked off and it ends up in the corner. Wasberg finds it. Far side, Stibbe strips it. Plays out to neutral. It was behind Armstrong Kincaid. Can he chase it down? He and Stauber come together. Stauber wins it and then fires one out to neutral. They'll wave off icing, so the Toros have to chase and play. This is where we were last night about this time. 3-3 in the third. The wheels came off for the Toros after a disallowed goal. Shot save made by Garrity, who's then crashed into. Meanwhile, Stibbe has it and finds Armstrong Kincaid. Armstrong Kincaid speeds onto the attack. Delays. Now he finds Russell. Shot into the glove for a whistle.
Get out those 50-50 raffle tickets. The winning 50-50 raffle ticket.
Offensive zone draw coming.
$13 is blue ticket.
Shots on goal coming into the period were 24-17 in favor of the Toros. Toros have two. Bobcats have three this period. Toros control the draw. Bjorgi dumps it down into the corner. Clevin puts it on net. Save made. Rebound given. And the Cats are on it. This is Hillman. Hillman chips around Bjorgi. And that will draw a call, so the Toros will be shorthanded for the first time tonight. You knew that was coming at some point. Hunter Bjorgi will go to the box. Interference, the call on Bjorgi. The Toros' kill is 13th in the league, 79.6%. The Bobcats' power play, 9th in the league, 23.1%, including two power play goals last night. Draw one back by Ness. Played around to the near side, Westland. Westland hoisted ahead. Klein gloves down to the stick. Quickly ahead for Grant Johnson. Leaves off far side. Irie looking back for Johnson. It's tipped on net, where it's swallowed up by Garrity. Toros, four shorthanded goals, eighth in the league in that category. Bobcats have given up six. That's 19th in the league. This place will go nuts if the Toros can get one here. Around to the near side. Toros clear the zone. Westland frees it up and pokes it down into the Bobcat end. Near side, Martell looks back across for Grant Johnson. He comes to Pekowski. Pekowski, shot save made, rebound given to the near side. Klein holds up top, looks across Martell. Back up top for Klein, drops back down to Martell. Martell walks in, looks back side of the play. Argindigi took it away. Argindigi looking to go two on one. Gives it up to Westland. Driving the net is JoJo Westland. Tripped down. Meanwhile, Cats back on the attack. Irie looks across. That pass was waist high for Johnson. Toros shouldn't expect any more favors from the official, and there they get it clear. Burns is hearing it from the fans as he skates back up ice. Meanwhile, the Toros break it up at the blue line. Punch it all the way down. 35 ticks left on the power play for the Bobcats. It's ahead for Chladek. Makes a move and dumps it into the corner. 23 seconds left on the power play. Kral takes it away and flicks it ahead. Puck's on edge. It'll roll all the way down. Miller out of his net. Leaves for Stauber. 11 seconds left on the Bobcat power play. Jopie, dumps it into the far corner. Skinner. Takes it away and plays it up the wall. Toros come full strength. Hillman takes it back. Westland steps in, but it's down low for Jopie. Jopie. Looking for help from Klein. He gets it and plays it down the wall. Armstrong Kincaid frees it up. Starts up ice. Armstrong Kincaid fights through. Guides it down into the corner. Shot from a tough angle, gloved and held for a whistle. 12:27 left to go here in the third. Toros and Bobcats even at three aside. A 21st birthday wish just went out. Along with a warning to be careful tonight. Draw will be to the right of Miller. Eventually. Draw will be to the right of Miller. Toro's control. Bjorgi, fresh out of hockey jail, dumps one down. Quick tip to the front, doesn't go. Cats looking to attack. Long shot, that goes wide. This is Dahlin on the attack for the Toros. Gains the line. He's got Peterson driving the net. Pass doesn't get there. Now Westland keeps it at the point, covering Peterson's point. A shot save made. Into the zone, Granis. Shot save made. Near side, and now Bartu is going to get called for the hold. So the Toros back to the kill. Draw to the left of Garrity. Hillman and Hargindigi or O'Connell. It'll be O'Connell who steps in. Cats control the draw. Gower fresh out of the penalty box for his 10-minute unsportsmanlike. Holding up top. Comes across. Quick shot save made by Garrity. And he gets the glove over top of the rebound. Draw to the left of Garrity. Gower controls for the Bobcats. Leaves off far side Jopi. Looks to go back to Gower, but it's taken away by Hargindigi. Jojo has Immonen with him. Jojo holding, delays, centering feed, gets blocked off. Jojo takes it back. He's in alone. It's in! Jojo! Toros lead 4-3. What a takeaway by Hargindigi. And the Toros take their first lead of the night. Here's the call of the goal.
Toros lap lighter down, scoring.
And that is offside.
Scoring shorthanded and unassisted, number 8, Joseph Hargindigi.
Shorthanded and unassisted for JoJo. Good song choice for the California kid. They play California Love over the PA after JoJo scores. I like it. Skinner finds the loose puck, sends it all the way down. Shots now 30-25 in favor of the Toros, who lead 4-3. 10:30 left to play here in regulation. Far side, long shot. Garrity snags it with the glove. Draw will be to the right of Benny. It'll be Ness on the draw for the Toros. Puck controlled by the Toros. Banked ahead and all the way down. Schladek into the zone. And it's ahead. Gower keeps it at the point. Sweeps across. Battle in front, it comes to Rodna. But Back across, Rodna flubs the one-timer in behind the net. Toro's come full strength. Cats still on the attack, however. Hillman pokes it down the wall. Kroll finds the loose puck. Gains the red and dumps it all the way down. And that goes for an icing. So the Toros get an offensive zone draw.
No pies, they didn't show up. Oh.
Draw will be to the left of Miller. 50-50 draw. Eventually comes to the near side. Clevin finds it, guides it back to the point. No, it's cut off by Hunter Olsen. Near side. Bjorgi plays across for Peterson. Peterson plays it around behind the net. It hops on Bjorgi. Stauber holding, looks across. Shot blocked out front. Clevin works it out to neutral. Russell frees it up, can't settle it down. This is Stauber leaving for Jack Olsen. Touched ahead by Schwartz. Peterson's bumped off the puck. That was an embarrassing dive, I believe. And it draws a call. Now a shot that goes wide. Unless it was a later infraction along the boards. Toro's back to the kill. Peterson. He's being sent off. What? What is the call here? At some point you have to tell the penalty box at least. I didn't see anything that looked like a guy should be sent off for the night. So Stibbe will serve the minor. Still waiting on the call. Are they calling a 5-minute major? No way. That's a huge call. Seven-minute power play for the Bobcats? No way.
Four hit from behind.
Hit from behind and a five-minute mate. So a two and a five serve, and it will all be served by number 20. So 7-minute power play for the Bobcats. For the hit from behind.
Two.
Also for the hit from behind. So the Toros will be shorthanded for 7 minutes. With 8 minutes and 13 seconds to play.
2 minutes tipped behind, 5 minutes on special teams.
Yeah. How is the Bobcat bench upset right now? They're getting 7 minutes of power play with 8:13 to go. This is unreal. So the Toros will be shorthanded for 7 minutes. 5 of it's a major, which means even if the Bobcats score on that portion, even if the Bobcats score on that portion, the Toros remain shorthanded. I assume the Bobcats wanted a 5-on-3 for the first 2 minutes. But this is Schladek. This is Gower. Gives to Rodna on the near side half wall. This is across Jopi. Up top, Gower comes across for Rodna. Tip play doesn't go. Garrity shuts it down to the near side as well. 6:13 left on the power play for the Cats. Jopi drops down to the side of the net. The Bobcat power play is deadly. We saw 2 power play goals against last night. Of course, the Toros have a shorty already tonight. Can they clear this? Gower did not keep it. And that will lead to a whistle. 5:55 left on the power play. This is Johnson bringing it to the far side. Irie plays down low for Pajkowski. Down low, Pajkowski. To Martell up top of the umbrella. Klein, top of the far circle. Martell shot gloved and held by Garrity. 5:32 left to play on the power play for the Cats. 6:45 in regulation. Draw to the right of Garrity. 50-50 draw. It was caught on the linesman's skate. Bobcats dig it out. Klein comes across to the near side. Johnson. Johnson shot. Tip out front. Ends up in the far corner. Martell is the first to it. 5:18 on the power play. Long shot. That's blocked. It comes back to Martell. Up top, Klein. Back across for Johnson. Johnson walks in, wires, that's blocked by Kroll. Johnson drops below the goal line, Pajkowski flubs it, second try doesn't go, Johnson can't get it, and now the Toros clear. Klein has to retreat and retrieve, the Toros get fresh killers on. I don't know if the minor or the major was first, so I don't know. The Toros may have killed the minor, there's 4:38 left to go. On the power play, this is Jopi looking across. Broken up, the Toros find it. Skinner tied up from behind, couldn't clear it all the way down. 4:23 on the power play. Hillman into the zone, falls down trying to elude the hit from Skinner. Skinner's into the bench, that shook him up. He went into the boards awkwardly. Hopefully just a Charlie horse. He's one of the Toros' main penalty killers. Shot him behind the net. Wasberg with a good hit. Puck squirts free. Toros find it and clear it all the way down. .344 And the Toros clear it again as the Bobcats couldn't quite gain the line. This will be Martell with 3:20 left on the power play. 4.5 left in regulation. The Toros protecting a one-goal lead, but shorthanded for a very long time. Good hit by Charchenko. Battling forward in the corner against Grant Johnson. It squirts free. Clevin finds it and punches it the length. 3 minutes on the power play for the Cats. 4:11 left to go here in period number three. Grant Johnson leaves off to the far side. Irie. Irie touches back to Martell. Martell walks in looking for a shot. In and out of the glove. Back to the near side. Hargindigi gets hauled down. Still makes the play and then sends it the length. Jojo chases after it. Klein has it on the far side. Hargindigi hassling him. 2:25 left. Far side, Ness finds it and clears it the length. Cats start up ice again. Gower comes to the near side. Chladek. Chladek fights through a check, carries down low. Plays to the far side. Skinner not missing a shift. Good to see him back out. The Cats still corral. Jopie working down low. Plays it back to the point in Gower. Minute 50 on the power play for the Cats. 3 minutes to play. Gower around behind. Leaves off far side Jopie. Jopie looking for a lane. Drops down low to Gower. Tip play doesn't go. Gary's got it underneath. Pile of bodies and the whistle goes. Garrity had it underneath, and then everyone just dogpiled him. A minute 33 left to go on the power play. 2:45 in regulation. Draw will be to the right of Garrity. Toros lead 4-3 with just over 8 minutes left to play. The Toros were sent to a 7-minute PK. There's only a minute 33 of that left. Toros find it. They fail to clear. Gower keeps it at the point. For now, Miller stays in the net. 1:23 left on the power play. They've got Rodna sneaking back. Dory fans on the one-timer. Armstrong Kincaid gets there first. Armstrong Kincaid speeds ahead. He gets away from Hillman. No, Hillman catches him from behind. Armstrong Kincaid holds on. Now he just chips it back to the Toro end. And the Toros ahead for Armstrong Kincaid. He's in. Shot. Save made by Miller. This place would have gone nuts if Armstrong Kincaid had buried that one. The call on Peterson was head contact, or no, checking from behind and unsportsmanlike conduct. Timeout taken by the Bobcat bench. So the Cats take their timeout. With 1:01 left on the power play. Wasberg, his first as a Toro, 1:11 into the third, tied the game. And Hargindigi, with a hard-working play on the penalty kill all by himself, stripped a puck after initially getting stopped on the rush, took the puck back, turned it around, and buried it behind Andrew Miller. Shots on goal are now 35-31 in favor of the Cats. A good chunk of those have come on this power play. And now the Toros have an offensive zone draw. 101 left on the kill. ...50-50 draw eventually found by the Cats. Near side. Gower starts up ice. Looks into the middle. They leave it off to the far side. Miller breaks for the bench. Final 2 minutes of regulation. Empty net for the Bobcats. 6-on-4. They're in the attacking zone for 40 seconds. Then the Toros will get Cade Stibbe back. This is Gower up top. Gower leaves off far side. 34 seconds left on the kill. Gower, top of the umbrella again. Holding. Holding comes to the near side. Rodna. Rodna from the near circle. Looking for a lane. Drops it to the side of the net. Fanning on it there was Chladek, but it's picked up by Jopi. Jopi looks up top for Gower. Gower shot through traffic. Tipped up and over. Skinner finds it first. Skinner looks to eat it along the wall. Just 13 seconds left in the kill for the Toros. The Toros have it. Empty net. If O'Connell can get his feet moving, he does. Shot for the empty net. Post! OC bounces one off the post. That would have put the game away. Final, a minute 11. The Toros have killed it off completely. Centering feed. Shot. It's in. Rodna. With a minute 6. Has tied the game. Unbelievable. ...106 left in regulation. O'Connell bounces one off the pipe for the empty netter. That would have iced it away. The Cats come down the other way and tie the game. Armstrong Kincaid into the zone. Armstrong Kincaid gets it to Stibbe. Stibbe back to Charchenko. Charchenko's shot is blocked. There's a broken stick down in the corner. It belongs to Armstrong Kincaid. Toros working the offensive zone. Near side. Clevin lost it. It's loose for Jacob Marty. Jacob Marty. Shot blocked. 33 seconds left to go in regulation. It's dumped down low for Charchenko. This is Bjorgi. Flicks it into the zone. And Miller will hold for a cover. Draw will be to the right of Miller. And it's all the way down. Will it go for icing? It won't. For some reason. 8 seconds in. Hillman fans on a shot. And we will head to overtime. So, we go to overtime, even at 4-a-side. We will take a short break here, come back with the extra session after these messages here on the Minotauros Network.
Captain's Cove Seafood Restaurant invites you in for your favorite seafood as well as steak, chicken, and lots of great burgers and sandwiches. The Cove has fish and chips, crab, shrimp, and all-you-can-eat meals. Captain's Cove, where fishing is made easy. 1735 South Broadway in Minot.
Throughout the areas we serve, First International Bank and Trust employees are actively involved in helping our customers and communities grow. This is Kevin Vigestead from First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Whether it's coaching a little league team, leading through involvement with nonprofit organizations, or a proud Beaver booster, know that all of us at First International Bank and Trust are committed to giving back to the places where we live and work.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink. 2,148 people packed into the Pepsi to watch a barn burner. The Toros fell behind early, fought back, only to have to kill 7 minutes of power play time with 8:13 left in regulation. The Toros killed it, then had a chance at the empty net. Cole O'Connell banked one off the pipe. And the Bobcats came back the other way and tied it. So we go to overtime. It's ahead. Armstrong Kincaid in alone. Backhand try, follow-up doesn't go either. Cats go the other way now. Jacob Marty poked away from him by Armstrong Kincaid. Jacob Marty holding, looks across for Gower. Gower takes it back out to neutral. Here come the Toros. This is Immonen. Immonen gets around Klein. Shot blocked up and out of play for a whistle. So, draw will be to the right of Miller. Cats control. Carried ahead by Martell. He lost the handle and Clevin takes over. 4:02 left to go in the extra session. Clevin find some space on the far side and gains the lot. No, a very late offside call. A back and forth game. And now the Cats control the draw with 3:50 left to go here in extra time. Klein holding. Delays. And now we'll turn back. Olsen. Olsen carries down low. Wraparound try doesn't go. Buchholz holds and drops back for Skinner. Ahead for Stibbe. Stibbe up ice. Looking for help. He's buying time. Dumped down low. Skinner leaves it for Stibbe. He can't take it away. It's up ice for Hillman. JoJo's the only guy back. And he defends it nicely. And now he wants to turn. JoJo on the attack. Comes across for Kroll. Kroll for Stibbe. Stibbe back for JoJo. A good stick by Goward breaks that up. This is carried into the zone by Rodna. Looking for his third of the night. Follow-up try. Garrity makes both saves. I was wrong on the number. It's 21-54 is tonight's attendance. This is Rodna. Just falls down. Behind the net, Pikowski. There's one thrown towards the net, but wide. Coming on is Grant Johnson. Shot blocked, and Garrity can't quite get on the top, but Russell's there. Quickly ahead, Armstrong Kincaid in behind the defense. Armstrong Kincaid to end it. And Miller makes the save. 1:39 left in the extra session. This is Skinner. Skinner broke, has that broken up. And now the Cats look to attack. Armstrong Kincaid harassing Granis up the ice. Granis in. Looking backside, and now a penalty coming on Immonen. It's a trip. So the Cats get another power play.
Five on four.
So 1:22 left. Draw to the right of Garrity. Gower holding, looks across. Jopi back up top. Shot goes up and over, and the rebound will be kept by Gower. Gower walks in, wires, that's blocked. Rebound loose in the slot. Crawl gets hauled down, and we'll go back to evens. So so, we're going for a side, apparently. You would think they'd go 3-on-3. Why are they going 4-on-4? It will be three aside. Three on three once again. Cats control. This is Klein. Far side for Hillman. Hillman walks along the blue line, loses the handle. And now Skinner in alone. Skins, shot save made, rebound hacked at, still loose, doesn't go, Skinner trying to get to it, he can't shovel it in. Final 30 seconds. 26 as the Cats start up ice. This is Hillman cutting to the middle. Shot blocker save. Rebound to the far side. Jopi guides it back to Hillman. Final 13 seconds. Stauber. As Jopi forced out to neutral. Jopi back on the attack. Drops for Johnson. Shot blocked by Buchholz. And we'll head to a shootout. Well, 2,154 fans certainly getting their money's worth tonight. So, we head to a three-round shootout. Cats will shoot first, and it's Rodna. Rodna in. Garrity makes the save. First up is Russell for the Toros. Russell up the middle. Delays, head fake, and a blocker save by Miller. Grant Johnson, the next shooter for the Cats. Grant Johnson up the middle, delays, shot. Garrity makes the save. Next shooter for the Toros is Isaac Dolan. Dolan veers to the right. Moves in slowly, now cuts the middle, head fake, and he can't quite stuff it. Miller, a little slow to get up after getting crashed into. In comes Magnuson. Delay, stutter, step, and he scores. So now, Immonen must score. Immonen with speed up the middle. Shot save made. Toros lose. The Cats sweep the weekend in what was a thriller of a game. We'll take a commercial break and come back with the wrap after these messages here on the Minotoros Network.
His wife's words echoed in his mind.
You never fix anything around here.
Well, today that would change. He would fix the water heater. He'd show her that he was the handyman of this house. He was more than capable. Oh, no.
covered it. August 14th, 2008. Talk to farmers. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two.
We are farmers. Bum, 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 bum.
Underwritten by Farmers Truck Fire Insurance Exchanges and Affiliates. Products not available in every state.
Hey, Toro fans. Ken Oda here. Whether you need to insure your auto, home, or life, call the Miranda Schuler Farmers Agency at 838-8144. Or better yet, do what I do and stop in. They keep free candy on their desks.
Whoa, what was that?
That's the sound of someone getting one of America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
Hey, there's mine.
Tired of waiting for your tax refund? Let the professionals at Liberty Tax help you discover America's fastest refunds. Find us at libertytax.com or call 866-871-1040 today to find a location near you. That's 866-871-1040. Liberty Tax Service, where we put the fun
and the speed
back into doing your taxes. America's fastest refunds from Liberty Tax.
I guess I don't have to tell you that I've been unsatisfied with your performance lately. You're showing your age. I think I even see a bald spot. It's time for Tires Plus.
Tires Plus has the prescription to satisfy all your vehicle needs, from tires to repair. Stop settling for average performance. Trust your locally owned Tires Plus. Some common side effects may occur, such as family safety, feelings of happiness, strange smiles that last all day, free courtesy rides, and raccoon hands. Actually, that's not real. I was just checking to see if you're listening. Thinking tires, think Tires Plus.
The Job Connection, brought to you by Classic Hits 1390 KRRZ.
Coulter Energy is hiring day supervisors, night operators, and field assistants. Must be able to pass a drug and alcohol test along with a physical. Must be able to work away from home in extended hours. Coulter Energy offers competitive wages, including drive time wage and non-taxable per diem, and benefits. Send resume to jobs at coulterenergy.ca or online at coulterenergy.com. Coulter Energy is an equal opportunity employer.
For info about this job and others, head to classichits1390.com.
Welcome back inside the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena. The Toros fall 5-4 in a shootout. That was easily one of the most exciting games I've seen in a long time here in this building. Cats struck first. Stauber from Granis at 5:16 of the first gave the Cats a 1-0 lead. 8:35 of the first, Hunter Olson from Stauber and Schwartz made it 2-0 Cats. Sam Skinner from Buchholz at 11:46 of the first pulled the Toros back within one, and then Jack Westland at 7:42 of the second tied it with help from Braden Bartu. Cats took the lead again, though, as Lars Christian Rodney from Gower and Jupi at 13:26 of the second had it 3-2 going into the third. Wilhelm Wasberg, his first as a Toro, 1:12 in to the final period, tied the game. And then at 8:55, Joseph Hargindigi, a shorthanded goal, just a hard-working goal for his fourth of the season, gave the Toros a 4-3 lead. Then, with 8:13 to play, Ryan Peterson gets a 5-minute unsportsmanlike conduct major and a 2-minute checking from behind minor, putting the Toros shorthanded for the next 7 minutes. They killed all 7 minutes off, and it looked like they were going to go on to win.
Skate with the Toros. Oh my God, really?
Then, after killing all 7 minutes, it looked like the Toros would go on to win, but with 1:06 remaining, Rodna, his second of the game, tied it. And then in the shootout, Magnuson scores the only goal in the third round for the Bobcats. Toros had no answer. On Imanen's last chance, and the Toros fall 5-4. That will do it for us here tonight on the Pepsi Rink at Mesa Arena. We'll be back at it on Tuesday, New Year's Eve. The Toros head down to Bismarck to try and avenge these two losses this weekend. So until Tuesday night, I'm Ken Oda, hoping you enjoy the broadcast in spite of the outcome. We'll talk to you on Tuesday.
This has been a presentation of Minotauros Hockey. Visit MinotaurosHockey.com to stay up to date on all things Toros. This broadcast was brought to you by Farmers Union Insurance, Gooseneck Implement, Mattress Firm, Liberty Tax, and Coulter Energy. Minotauros Hockey, join the charge.